I'm going to spend a little bit of time going over how you're going to access the course and the first assignments that we're going to work on. My name is Dr. John Rise. I'm going to be your instructor this semester for Psychology 49. So let's go ahead and take a look at the email first that I sent you. If you open up that email message, I'm going to move this over. I'm sure you've already read this, of course. You'll see there's a copy of the course syllabus. I'm going to open up that course syllabus file. The course syllabus, as you've already seen, is really extensive. It has a table of contents, actually, which started as a joke between a faculty member friend of mine and I, because my syllabus had gotten to be about 13 or 14 pages long. But actually, I find that the table of contents is actually a good way to sort of look for particular things you might be interested in, such as prerequisites, the student learning outcomes that I expect you to master by the end of the course. More importantly, actually, probably my contact information. Oops. Clicking on things when I shouldn't be. My contact information, my office hours, which are Mondays from 12:30 to 1:30 in NSB 149, which is the Natural Sciences Building, which is where the rest of the psychology program is. If you cannot make those hours, you can also set up an appointment. I'm happy to meet with you at other times. In addition, you'll see course materials, including the textbooks. The one that is most critical, and I will just scroll down to this, is the Grisson and Gazzaniga third edition of the textbook, and there's even a photo there to help you find it. This has a lot of information, including there is a California edition of the textbook that is an ebook that you can buy for $39.95. That includes an access code that you'll need to complete the online homework. You can also rent the textbook if you wanted. If you want to do that, you just need to make sure that you buy the access code for the inquisitive homework, which is $25. Okay. If you want a physical copy of the textbook, I personally like having a physical copy. There is both a paperback and a loose leaf version you can buy in the bookstore or from the publisher directly using the link that's provided here. In addition, we will be using APA citation style. You may have done MLA, the Modern Language Association. We will be using APA. If you're a psych major, you should buy the publication manual because you're going to need it. If you're not a psych major, it's not required, but it might be helpful. But there are some other sources that you'll have online that you can access for free that will be useful in this class. But again, if you're a psych major, I would encourage you to buy it later. Okay. Most importantly, we are going to be using Canvas for all of our online course assignments, exams, online course lectures, a lot of material in the course. Okay. So in addition to what we have in lecture in class, we're also going to have some online components. Mills College, for the most part, uses Blackboard, but actually we are in the process of investigating other computer systems. So in this class, we're actually going to pilot out Canvas. If you've used Canvas elsewhere, you probably have had the same experience which I've had, which is that I find Canvas to be really much more user-friendly and student-friendly, but you'll get a chance to give me some feedback on that. If you click on either the link or the Canvas login page, they will both take you to the Mills authentication service. You just type in your normal login information and your password that you've set up. If you've never done this, you've never logged into the Mills portal, you'll need to set that up, and the instructions are actually found here in how to set up your password for the first time, including hyperlinks. Okay, so that should get you started. Otherwise, you can have it remember you if you're on your own computer. Click sign in. And what you're going to see is it's going to take you to the dashboard that's going to look a little bit different than Blackboard. But you can see a calendar of all the assignments in the course, which I'm going to go over in just a minute, and a set of all of your courses that have Canvas. Now, at this point, it's probably only the Fundamentals of Psychology course from fall of 2019. So you will click on that. And that is going to show you, let me scoot this over a bit so you can see it. That's going to show you a variety of sources that are available to you. It's going to make a change. Here we go. So you should see exactly what I'm seeing on the screen. You'll see the homepage, which has a general overview of the course. It has a link to email me directly. In addition, you can also use the Canvas inbox to send me an email. Either one of those will get to me at the same email address. If you need help with textbook or publisher problems, materials, the inquisitive assignments, or your e-textbook is not working, you'll use this link for Norton support. Otherwise, I've got all the deadlines. As I said in the email, you know, unfortunately, I cannot be here today. I cannot be here on Wednesday, August 28th. But we will have an orientation online that you can participate in. Otherwise, our first physical in-class meeting will be Wednesday, September 4th. The last day to add is September 11th. The last day to drop is Wednesday, September 25th. And the last day to drop with a W is November 6th. Okay? We will end on December 9th. And our final exam is actually scheduled for Monday, December 16th. Okay? You can see all the information in the course, including the syllabus, by clicking on this link. Or if you scroll up, there's a syllabus link right here. In addition, there are discussions. If there's any questions you have in the course, you can post those in that area. And then, of course, accessing your grades. Okay, so if I continue to scroll down, you'll see a lot of information in this course. And I know it may be initially overwhelming. I encourage you to take it in chunks. Come back to the Canvas course as often as you want. As with everybody at Mills, I'm going to ask you your preferred gender pronouns. And we will cover that on Wednesday, November 8th. If you're not familiar with preferred gender pronouns, including singular they, them pronouns, there is an article here that you can click on. Or maybe you're familiar, but your parents or your friends are really not familiar or really resistant to using those. Click on that article or send it to them. Give them some information to help them out. You are going to need a copy of the textbook. You can buy a physical copy using this link right here, or you can buy the California edition of the textbook using this link for $39.95. Or you can buy the registration code for $25 if, for example, you're using a used textbook or you're sharing a textbook with a friend. There are going to be a couple of copies in the library that you can check out for 2 hours at a time. Really helpful if you're waiting on financial aid or you're waiting for a paycheck to be able to buy the textbook. That will help you at least in the beginning. Again, you are going to need to buy the Inquisitive for $25 at least. And I think it might get difficult to keep up with the reading if all you're doing is using the one from the library. But if you're really organized and it's worked for you in the past, I'm okay with you doing that here. If this is your first semester in college, you're not sure about how to write emails to professors, one of the things you have to do is you have to help me out with as much information as possible. That means you need to give me your name. You need to give me what class you're in. You need to give me what section you're in, because we do teach three sections of this Psychology 49 class. In addition, you need to give me screenshots if it's a technological problem, or even a screenshot video would also be helpful. Try to help me as much as possible so that we don't have this back and forth. Please make sure if you're sending an email from a non-Mills email address, it may not necessarily include your name. So I would always encourage you to include your first and last name, as much information as possible that you may need for what you need from me. That will help me to help you as quickly as possible. Okay. There is a link here to talk about how to write professional emails. I encourage you to read it if you're not familiar with how to write professional emails. It will be helpful not only at Mills, but anywhere in your professional life after this. Okay. The course is divided up into week-long blocks. This first week, which is for August 28th, is just really an introduction to the course. Again, there's no lecture that week. It's just this orientation video and reading the syllabus. If you click on each of these hyperlinked blue folders, you'll see and you will get access to any of the course materials. Okay. So this first one is just kind of getting you used to the course. There are two assignments you're going to work on in there. So if I click on this one, I can follow it. And what you're going to see is it's got that other link about how to write emails to instructors, so just kind of make sure you look at it. The course syllabus, a syllabus quiz to make sure you've read that 15-page syllabus. Again, the syllabus quiz is really going to focus on things that are most important in the beginning of the class. When's the last day to drop? When's the last day to add? Learning outcomes for the course. When are the first assignments due? Okay, those are going to be the things you're going to focus on. In addition, the Inquisitive assignment, this is just a sort of getting you used to and comfortable with using Inquisitive. So click on that and it will walk you through the process. That is worth points. The syllabus quiz is worth 30 points. The Inquisitive assignments each week are worth 15. Okay. The majority of your grade really comes from those quizzes that we're going to do every week. If you're not familiar with how to set up a Norton Inquisitive account, there is a link here which will sort of walk you through that process. Okay. But just use this link right here to get that all set up. Okay. Once you've completed that, you will be ready to go, and you can click on any of these, and it will give you the due dates. Those are both due on Thursday, September 5th. So in case you're not familiar with how to use Inquisitive, or you haven't had a chance to set it up, and you want me to walk you through in class or in my office hours, I can do that once I'm back, okay? So please feel free, if you want to, give it a try right now, get it done and over with. Otherwise, it's going to be due both those assignments, both the syllabus quiz, and the first Inquisitive assignment are going to be due on Thursday, November 5th. Okay. Next, the next module we're going to work on, which will be what we're going to work on in class, So on Wednesday, September 4th, we're going to have an icebreaker activity, kind of getting to know each other. And then what you're going to see in this module and what you're going to work on separately, the lecture quizzes for this first week are going to be delivered online. So you can see there are three short video lectures, and you can watch those at any time. And then there's the Chapter 1 Inquisitive Assignment again and a Chapter 1 exam. All the exams you can take three times. It will take your highest score. They are timed. You have 30 minutes to complete them. If you need any accommodations for extra time, please let me know so that I can get those set up in the system. In addition, every module has additional resources you'll see. So you can click on this additional resources link. It will take you to things that I think might be potentially helpful for you. A career one-stop center if you're thinking about what you want to major in or what you want to do with your life for jobs. The APA Psychology as a Career link, which talks about what you can do with a psych degree if you're interested. And then lastly, Skeptics Dictionary, which I love because it talks about all these ideas like, can we actually read minds? Are zombies real? All that kind of stuff. This provides two articles to kind of myth bust some of the common things like telepathy and astrology that people often believe in. So there are lots of resources in this class to help you get started. Hopefully that gets you answers a couple of questions. If you have anything else, please feel free to send me an email. I am happy at any time. Otherwise, I will see you in our group chat, again, which you can see in the email. The live video conference is going to be from 11 to 12:15, and you can either join. I encourage you to join on your computer because I will be walking through the course again and how it's set up, and I guess you'll also get an in-person chance to interact with me and ask questions. But otherwise, if you can't, if you're not near your computer, you can use an iPhone or you can dial in. But then you may just want to have your computer open near you. You're going to need to download the Zoom app to be able to do this. So maybe just take a few minutes to download that Zoom app so you're all ready. Lastly, if you know anyone who's trying to add the course, there's plenty of room in this class to add the course. All you have to do is make sure that they get the signature of their advisor. They do not need my signature because we've got about 20 spots or so in the course. So if you know anyone who's interested, please send them my way. Send them the copy of the email so they can sort of help get set up. Great. Thank you very much. Email me with any questions.